At a Sheetz convenience store in Ohio, an employee apparently quit after being given just 3 months to comply with a smile policy that they have. And to comply, they would have to get dental surgery. We're gonna give you all the details. This company, Sheetz, forbids employees from working with, quote, obvious missing, broken, or badly discolored teeth unrelated to a disability, and gives them 90 days to fix the issue. Rose, the employee, said the manager asked her for a detailed timeline showing when the procedures would take place and how much they would cost. There is no case to be made that you should require your employees to do this. But of all of the worst cases in which to try to force this on someone, the fact that this employee had lost many of her teeth due to domestic abuse by an ex-spouse, and then forcing them to deal with it with an expensive dental procedure on pain of losing your job is just absurd. Rose eventually just quit, said at that point, to be honest, I didn't want to be there anymore. Said that the manager was newly promoted and was handling this type of situation for the first time. Apparently, this policy applies to current employees, prohibits hiring workers with visible dental issues. So to work at a convenience store in a country where people do not have guaranteed health insurance, let alone dental insurance, and we'll talk a little bit about the stats in a bit, that you would bar people from getting this job because their teeth are discolored or chipped or, dear God, no, missing. Absolutely insane, Maz. What do you think?
Wait, I can understand if they say it's bad breath. If you've ever been in a workspace, someone's got bad breath, you'd be like, woo, you gotta go. Now listen, man, it's stupid. By the way, when you said Sheetz, I thought Sheetz was like a Sheetz store. And I was starting to think, gosh, why are people that are in the business of beddings and pillows and sheets such bad people? But I'm happy to find out that it's not just beddings and sheets, because you know, the My Pillow guy, now Sheetz. Yeah, this is ridiculous, and the lady deserves to win a lawsuit. I mean, again, it's one thing to say, look, we're giving you dental insurance, and you know, you take advantage of it. You know, that's a great, hey, that's what a great boss. I'm giving you dental insurance. Take advantage. If you want to fix it, you do what you got to do. Yeah, you can't in this day and age. What are you thinking? You can't go up to someone and say, oh, you're gonna be fired because. You know, you're, and by the way, like you just said, the abuse thing is another issue, which is it's not like the lady, you know, had natural teeth that just hadn't been aligned and needed the teeth aligned. By the way, do they have some sort of, did anyone dig to find out if Sheetz had some sort of deal with a dental office and they were getting kickbacks?
I haven't seen anything like that. It's just,
you should send your investigative reporter, John.
I'm looking into it.
I think there's a Sheetz dental collusion going on that no one's looking into. Yeah, there's a class action lawsuit waiting to happen now.
We're coming for you, 1-800-DENTISTS. We're gonna figure out what's going on. Anyway, as terrible as this is, and by the way, they point out they maintained this policy during the pandemic when the employees' mouths would be covered at all points by a mask. They still had it. Anyway, they apparently just wanted everyone to get a smile when they walked in the door. I haven't ever worked at a convenience store. I've worked retail before, but I imagine it's already a difficult job. You generally are gonna be the only person in there having to manage a whole bunch of things simultaneously, being constantly worried about shoplifters, being worried about being held up at gunpoint, dealing with all of this for long hours, sometimes in the middle of the night. And now you have to worry about your teeth getting a little bit too yellow. Devastating. So look, there's been a lot of pressure. Oh, really fast, Maz, let me just give people the update. Insider had apparently already been looking into this, and now with this high profile case starting to get covered, Sheetz is rescinding its smile policy effective immediately, which you can give them however much credit you think it's worth them getting for taking this away in response to this terrible thing happening. In some ways, by the way, the company is a little bit progressive. They give 12 weeks of paid maternity leave, which is more, you know, than some places do. So that's something. And look, I'm not saying there's nothing good about Sheetz or whatever, but this was just absurd, and it shouldn't have taken this sort of scandal to get rid of it. Sorry, Maz, what were you gonna say?
You made a good point about these poor people getting held up, and they have to have nice teeth. So the guy robbing them goes like, "Give me all your money." By the way, great teeth.
Yeah.
But what about, here's an idea. What if they give everybody grills? Can you imagine if you went into Sheetz and everyone had grills? You're going, hey, why does everybody have grills? New company policy. We all got to have the grills. Just a thought.
It's just bizarre. Anyway, I want to make sure that people understand some of the context of this. So the cost of dental care usually paid out of pocket by Medicare recipients. Average out of pocket spending on dental services among even people who have Medicare, $874 back in 2018. 1 in 5 Medicare beneficiaries use dental services, spend more than $1,000 out of pocket on dental care. It can be, yeah, it can be really expensive. I you know, we're lucky at TYT. I have the privilege. We have insurance, we have dental insurance. My insurance had a bit of a mix up where we had some minor change to the plan or whatever, but it was such that it needed to be updated with the dentist or whatever. So I got a bill under the old insurance, which wasn't working. So I got the full bill. And my heart almost stopped when I saw it was for a crown. I got a crown and my stomach like seized up. I eventually realized that they had the wrong information. It's still gonna cost money, but there are so many people that don't have insurance or have dental insurance that barely covers anything. And you still have to spend a ton, even for simple things, let alone the replacement of a tooth or something like that. This is why like we did so much talking about Bernie Sanders' plan to expand coverage of dental care under Obamacare. And that was considered too radical, too extreme in America that we should have teeth that we can maintain. We live in a backwards country.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.